Mango is a very interesting fruit. It's a nostalgic fruit. It's not a fruit to eat. It's a fruit to dream. I've always been a plant collector. I will say since I was a child. So it's in my blood. And then professionally, it was a perfect match for me. I'm a forestry engineer, and I dedicate for the past 20 years to look for the perfect mango. The process started, I will say, 100 years ago. I'm just continuing the research. The breeding program started at Fairchild Tropical Garden 5 years ago. At the moment, we have 600 hybrids that are under research. You know, sometimes when people listen about hybrids, they have a misconception and they immediately relate it with GMOs. What we are doing is we are setting the date. We are putting two of these wonderful mangoes and we put them in a cage. If they are close enough and they like each other, they will set a new hybrid. We have already one of our new hybrids. For me, it's so excited, it's like my baby. So the new hybrid that you are going to see, it's a small mango, very fragrant. It has the color that people want. It's not purple yet, but I'm hoping that we can get that purple mango, and it's very resistant to diseases. So you can have that mango for over 2 weeks and not black spots at all. It's painful because you have to wait, you are just putting nature together and wait what happened, and then just select the mangoes that you are looking for. That process is painful because it takes time. We have trees and still haven't been able to produce fruit, so we can start evaluating them. We have to wait 2 more years to do that, and then we have to cross them again. So I'm talking about that in order to release this new generation of mangoes, it's going to take us 6 more years. It is very painful, but I think it's worth it. I'm very happy with the preliminary results. We have the base here for the new generation of mangoes.
Your story segments brought to you in part by the Brunetti Foundation.